Well, it looks like the false flags that are going to trigger World War III are already being raised. Footage of false flag chemical attacks is already being filmed and distributed, and is expected to be on Western news on wall-to-wall coverage by the end of today. That is 9/11/2018. The United States government wants World War III not only to conceal the economic reality of our stagnating economy, but because Russia and China are a direct threat to the petrodollar. Make no mistake, this is done entirely under false pretenses and with anything but good intentions. You are going to be lied to by bloodthirsty, psychotic monsters. Do not fall for this. The White Helmets are not impartial humanitarians. They are British intelligence and the State Department trying to justify their own war. Oh hi, I'm the Heretic. So 17 years ago, today, a group of 19 mostly Saudi nationals hijacked four American airplanes. The first of them, a Boeing 767 on American Airlines, crashed into the North Tower of the World Trade Center at 8:45 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. At 9:03, the South Tower was struck by another 767, leading to their eventual collapse. Another flight, a Boeing 757, crashed into Washington, D.C., striking the Pentagon, the headquarters of the U.S. Department of Defense. Flight 93 crashed in a field in Pennsylvania after passengers took the plane back from hijackers. According to Abu Zubaydah, believed to be one of the 9/11 organizers, the intended target of Flight 93 was the White House. But come on, you know this stuff already. I'm only reminding you because it's a tremendous milestone in our nation's history and for the worse. So it's times like these when emotions ran high, and continue to do so, recalling that horrible day when nearly 3,000 people died because Allahu Akbar. Where were you when it happened? Well, I was in government school. I mean, I had no idea anything had even happened that day. Granted, I had no situational awareness to speak of, and I still don't, but I had no reason to think it would be any other day. I didn't notice any teachers acting funny. I didn't walk by anyone crying or see the teacher's lounge door partially open with everyone huddled around a TV screen. My first inclination that anything weird was going on was when I came home and my mom started yelling in a panic, "Turn on the news! Turn on the news!" Why? I thought. Younger me believed that the news was just boring, grown-up stuff. No, turn on the news, turn on the news, we're under attack. Okay, okay. So, we turn on the news. It would have been 2:40 Eastern Standard Time when it hit me just what had happened. Our country rallied together, and the world came to our support. That day, there were no Democrats, no Republicans, just Americans. And what did the state do in that period of great unity? Completely eliminate any pretense the United States has as a free country by creating a gigantic surveillance state whose only purpose will be to determine which of the three felonies you committed today they'll prosecute you for once you become inconvenient. They went to war in Afghanistan to fight against Al-Qaeda and their sponsors in the Taliban, which would go on to be the longest-lasting war in U.S. history, despite taking down the Taliban in 2 months. Basically, the government exploited a crisis to seize our liberty. Let's not also forget some of the shenanigans regarding 9/11 itself. The fact that it was orchestrated by Osama bin Laden, a former CIA asset in the Mujahideen. The official government 9/11 reports, the last 28 pages were classified for 14 years. In the collapse of World Trade Center Building 7 for unspecified reasons, minutes after a report was made of the building's eventual demolition, because nobody's entirely sure how two planes can demolish three buildings. Just the day before, September 10, 2001, Donald Rumsfeld, then Secretary of Defense, announced the Pentagon had lost $2.3 trillion. They just lost it. While little attention or investigative power was poured towards figuring out how the attacks were paid for in the first place. Shenanigans. But don't you dare ask any questions about how it is a terrorist's passports could survive crashing into the World Trade Center or what role the Saudis played in funding this disaster, or even the use of waterboarding for 2 to 3 years. Because if you do, then you're a crazy wild conspiracy nut. Because we have a violent, coercive monopoly that seeks to exist at your expense, horrors such as 9/11 will be used as a means of tightening the noose of the state around our necks. Heads they win, tails you lose. While we remember what happened and where we were on that horrible day, where thousands of family members lost their loved ones for stupid reasons, let us remember what Al-Qaeda sought to do. Provoke the United States into a quagmire of a war that would deplete the treasury and damage the economy. They learned this strategy from the CIA in the priesthood of statism, who fell for it themselves, hook, line, and sinker. Questions, comments, critique? Where were you on 9/11/2001? What do you think is the shadiest part about the official government story about what happened? Leave your comments below. Support me through Patreon. Like, share, and subscribe to become a heretic today.